You've already seen several functions that take in two numbers and return a number, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The functions star, triangle, and circle all take in a number and two strings, returning an image. That's where the contract comes in. A contract is a tool to help us document all the functions in our language. It's like an instruction manual for a specific function. Let's use the triangle function as an example. Each contract is made up of three parts: the name, the domain, and the range. The name should be pretty self-explanatory, and in this case, the name of our function is triangle. The domain of a function is a list of the types of data the function expects in the order it expects them. It's important to understand that the domain is not the names of the inputs, like size, style, or color, but the data types they expect, like number and string. The final element of our contract is the range, which tells us the data type that a function returns. The triangle function has a range of image. We use types instead of values when we write a contract because we want to be more general. A star could be any size, so the domain for the star specifies that the first input could be any number value. If we think of a language as a collection of Lego pieces, the contracts are the tabs and slots that tell us how each piece can connect. As you encounter, and eventually write, more functions, you'll want to document their contracts in the contract log. The log will serve as your manual for the language, which will be really helpful when you start to write more complex programs. In the next stage, you'll get a chance to use a number of different functions and then write a contract for each one. Make sure that you also add these contracts to your log for reference later on.